would wait and watch from far away, but you always knew that you'd be the one to work while they all play. And you'd lay awake at night and scheme of all the things that you would change, but it was just a dream. Whoa!
Ladies and gentlemen, hang on a second. In the interests of safety, please save your applause for when Wesley is back on the ladder. Thank you.
Do not try this at home.
My name's Beth.
Beth, where are you from?
I'm from Devon originally, but I live in London.
Amazing. Okay. And you are going to be singing?
I am indeed.
Is that how you make a living?
Not at all. I'm a paediatric nurse. I work at a big children's hospital here in London.
Do you ever take your guitar to work?
I do, yeah. When I was a student, there was a boy who wanted to learn guitar, but he had nobody to teach him, so I said, oh, I can teach you. And then as I'd play with him, other parents would say, can you come into my kids' room and play? So I'd end up just going around the wards, just playing for the kids.
That's so cool. What an amazing thing to be able to bring a smile to all those faces.
It made me think, maybe I should give the whole music thing a go, so this is why I'm here today.
And Beth, are you going to sing a cover or an original song?
I'm singing an original song.
Good.
It's a difficult job, and part of processing a lot of the things that happen in the ward, I write songs. So the song I've written today is about what I've learned from my patients and their families. I'm not a parent myself, but I've got a snapshot of what it's like to love a child. So that's what inspired this song.
Good for you. Take a deep breath. Let's make the next 2 minutes count.
Okay. So this is called You Taught Me What Love Is.
You will never know how much I love you. And oh, you had to go, but I'm always thinking about you. If I could take your place, I'd do it a thousand times. Now there's a U-shaped hole in my life. And no, I won't be the same. You taught me to be brave, and although it wasn't for long, you taught me what love is. No, I won't be the same. You taught me to be brave, and although it wasn't for long, you taught me what love is. For just less than a year, I never slept at all. And I'll never sleep again if I could see you once more. You were too good for this world, this life. You were handpicked for paradise. No, I won't be the same. You taught me to be brave, and although it wasn't for long, you will never know how much I love you.
Do it, puts everything into perspective. And I just was thinking about my own children. I was choked up the whole time. Yeah. It was so beautiful. I think you're really, really special.
Once in a we found this show, you've got 2 minutes to change your life, and I think you've changed your life. But also, you know, you've touched all our lives too with that song. It was truly staggeringly beautiful, and you delivered it perfectly. Well
done. Thank you very much. Thanks.
You have such a difficult job. I don't know where you find the strength. Totally admire you for doing that selflessly every single day, but to also have this kind of talent is God-given, so you literally are an angel in every way, and I'm sure loads of parents at that hospital agree.
Beautiful song. Absolutely beautiful song.
Thank you.
The lyric is so poignant. You're a great singer, you're a great songwriter, you're a great person, so you just tick three boxes. Well done.
Thank you very much.
So, we'll take a vote.
I need to go first. I want to say yes.
Okay, good. It's a yes from me.
It's a yes from me.
Four yeses. Congratulations.
Thank you. Thank you so much.
I always say nurses are walking angels.
I was just thinking, in a way, you just don't want her to leave that ward, though, do you? Because she must spread so much joy on the ward.
It was amazing.
Thank
That's
you
so
much.
Moving.
Very special audition, that.
Well done.
Thrilled for you.
Go and celebrate.
All right, will do.
Congratulations.
Well done, Beth.
Thank you very much.
I'm going to do as many impressions as I can. And now, on ITVB, Chloe Sims.
I'm not digging you out. I'm not digging you out.
Cruising with Jane McDonald.
Oh, I love Jane.
Oh, yeah. Where's the sea friendly? Because it waves.
Who's that?
Jane McDonald. Right, I'm off for some fish pie. Back to loose women. Janet Street Porter.
Hello, I'm the JSP, I'm a rebel, rebel me, I...
And now, Aunt McPartlin. I just seen Joe Calzacchi and well done, Wacky.
Oh, why did she put the big forehead on, though?
Don't be cotton.
Oh, I'll show me my grand doctor leg.
I see that you've got a lot of nice rings there. Can I borrow that one, please?
This one? Okay.
Yeah, please. Perfect. Actually, you hold on to that for a minute.
Okay.
Right here, I actually have a handkerchief. There's nothing in it. I'll take the ring there. Now, I'm going to put it in the handkerchief under this. Perfect. If you can just hold on to your ring, please.
Okay.
All right. Now, I'll just... It's over. Now, Alicia, you're holding on to your ring. You can still feel it, yes?
Yes.
Okay, watch. Hold it up nice and high. Okay, if I just grab it by the corners, it's vanished.
Wow. Where's it gone?
All right. Now, Simon, my mum told me that it's your birthday this year. You're turning 80, so I brought you a gift. If you would like to open up your gift, you can just take it out by the ribbon.
Okay.
Now you can undo the ribbon and open the box.
Thank you.
Watch. Watch, I got you a watch, Simon.
Oh, that's a very nice watch.
Okay, would you like to put out your left hand for me, please?
My left hand, okay.
Perfect. Now I'm going to unscrew the back of the watch. Just like that. Now in this watch is something very special.
Crazy.
Alicia, whoa! Can you please take out what's in the watch?
Oh, my goodness!
Wow, that's very good.
Alicia, is that your ring?
That is my ring!
Now, Alicia, they say to never do the same trick twice, but today I feel like a rebel, so I'm going to break that rule.
OK.
Can I please have your ring again?
OK.
Let's get my magic wand. OK, watch. It's vanished. Now, Alicia, there's been a lot of amazing magicians on Britain's Got Talent, and a lot of them have done sleight of hand, okay? But today I'm going to do something completely different.
Okay.
And I call this sleight of foot.
What? That's a mean phase, isn't it?
Si el ritmo te lleva a mover la cabeza y empezamos como es. Mi música no discrimina a nadie, así que vamos a romper todo. ¿Y dónde está mi gente? ¿Y dónde está mi gente? Say yeah, yeah, yeah.
go.
What's your name, sir?
My name is Jon Courtenay.
Where are you from?
I live in a village called Mosley, which is near Manchester.
Oh, OK. Have you brought anyone with you?
I've got my wife and two boys, I hear.
Brilliant. How long have you played the piano?
Since I was about five, I guess.
And is that how you make a living?
Yeah.
So is this the biggest venue you've performed in?
Yeah. The Palladium is like the Holy Grail to me. I used to watch the shows with my dad, and this is the home of variety.
Oh.
Overwhelming. It's amazing.
Oh, he's so happy.
Good luck, John.
Thank you. This is bonkers.
There was a man who had a dream that Simon Cowell and his team would watch him play piano and try to slay them on the stage of the Palladium. And in the time that one song took, David would write another book. Alicia would smile at him. Amanda would be kind to him. Simon's teeth would be blinding him if he was smiling. But nothing now could ever spoil the dream he dreamed like Susan Boyle.
I like this already. Yes, John.
Let's see if we haven't been in it yet.
Fact is, he never thought he'd ever get to be in front of millions of people doing his thing on TV. 30 years of playing in piano bars and pubs, dodging glasses when they're thrown, being thrown out of clubs. When your children ask, Daddy, when are you coming home? This game is not the same when you're just Daddy on the phone. So he sits at the piano and he tries to get prepared, thinking he'll write it in third person so he doesn't feel as scared to sing about himself to a bunch of strangers in the dark. But then Britain has got talent and he wants to make his mark. Paul Potts won the first year and said it was insane. The second year, George Sampson won, singing in the rain. Lost Voice Guys, season 12. And last year, Colin Thackeray. So why not me?
Why not you?
That's what he said. His youngest boy, one night in bed. Dad, why not you? Go and show them what you do. And even though you'll be a wreck, at least you'll meet Anton Dare.
We're in it!
And he thinks on stage, at this stage in his life, with an expensive mortgage and a pensive wife. His youngest son, Alfie, says, what's it all about? If he had any hair left, he'd pull it out. His teenage son said, His dad taught him to play piano, but he didn't live to see his son at the famous theatre performing on TV. If he didn't see it through, imagine how sad the look on the faces of both his lads, who always tell him, you're the greatest showman, Dad. They'll see me on BGT. No more third person, just Daddy. This is me.
Thank you.
You've made me fall to bits, I don't know why. I just saw a man who kind of made all his dreams come true.
It really was, yeah.
David.
It was just so winning, wasn't it? Yeah. I mean, my goodness me, it made the whole audience, and I'm sure everyone watching at home, just fall in love with you.
I love him.
It had everything, and at the end, he had us moved to tears. This show is perfect for you, and now I want to see you go as far as you can in this competition.
Wow.
Well done.
Jon, it was just a wonderful audition. You're somebody who's worked for years, needs a break. You'll get a huge reaction of this, I promise you. And we all want you to do well. So I would love to be the first to say yes.
You deserve it. You deserve it.
Here's the other son. Here he comes.
I'm blinded by your grace. I'm blinded by your grace. Your grace, I'm blinded by your.
Lord, I've been broken, although I'm not worthy. You fix me, now I'm blinded by your grace. You came and saved me.
One time for the Lord.
I want to show you some very special skills that I learned in my previous job.
Ooh, I know, it is dangerous.
No.
It is dangerous.
In my hand I've got some tags, and they're numbered 1 to 6. And I give these a mix up. And Simon, I want you to select one tag. Try not to let anyone else see the number you choose.
Did I look at it?
Have a look at it.
Yeah.
And this is razor sharp commando dagger. I want you to place this dagger underneath one of the bags on the table that corresponds to the number you've just selected.
Done.
Now I'm going to try and guess the number you've selected by using the skills I learned in my previous job. Simon, I'm going to count down through the numbers 6 to 1. 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. I noticed a flicker on one particular number, and I know now it wasn't number one. I also know it wasn't 2 or 4. And it wasn't number 6. There were 2 numbers left, number 3 and number 5. Simon, look at me. Number 3, number 5. 3, 5. The number you chose was number 5. Now, let me tell you about my previous life.
I served in the military for 14 years, with the last 10 years as a Royal Marines Commando. A job which required me to routinely risk my life without fear. Ultimately, my time as a Marine taught me to trust my instincts, have courage in the face of danger, and to hold it together when lives are on the line. It is those skills that I'm going to be demonstrating tonight.
Having this sort of intuition, this sixth sense, has helped me in the past, and I'm hoping, aiming, it'll help me with tonight. There were 5 plungers in front of the judges. They're connected to these 5 boxes on stage. Cables come out the plungers and they're all mixed up so that nobody knows, not even me, which plunger is connected to which box. However, one plunger and one box are quite clearly connected. Simon, can you come forward, please, and push down plunger number 5? Give the handle a little bit of a twist and push that plunger down.
Jeez!
Oh my God!
There is an explosive device in each one of these 4 boxes on stage.
Nobody warned us about this!
Simon, please point to one of these 4 boxes. Whichever box you select is the box I will use. This one here. This intuition is a test of bravery, and some would say pure craziness. Simon, you're gonna make a series of choices, and I believe this is one of your better ones. Please choose a number between 1 and 4.
2.
Can you come forward and push down plunger number 2?
That's loud, that, eh?
It's loud!
Please choose another number, 1, 3, or 4. Push it down.
Wait, this is probably the best place for us to stand and watch this.
Simon, please name one of the remaining 2 plungers, but only push it down when I give you the thumbs up. 3 or 4. Which one are you going to go for?
3. 3.
We are now 50-50 from potential disaster. Simon, my intuition is telling me something.
Get back, or you'll have teeth flying everywhere.
Simon, there are some people that may think this explosive isn't real. Can you please push down the final plunger? I am the Magic Marine, Thank you and good night.
Yeah.
I need one of the judges.
God, no, not me.
David! David!
Hey. Get up there. Get up there.
And to deck are only little, you should use them. Hello. Take my jacket off.
Whatever happens, stay still.
Seriously. Seriously. What do I do? Stand still.
My heart would literally be in my mouth.
Lay down.
Oh God, he's not going to jump over him, is he?
Open your leg and keep your
open
mouth
my leg?
Yeah.
Please don't hurt our David.
Mm-hmm.